Welcome back to Nick Landis Comic Corner Classic Lesson Known Classics. This episode number 2283 and double shot number 2177. Now these two trades here have something common. They both feature comic books released back in the 1990s. First up we have is Incredible Hulk Epic Collection Volume 22 Ghosts of the Future. This book collects Incredible Hulk 436, 438, Savage Hulk, number 1, Cutting Edge, number 1, Cable 34, and Onslaught of the Marvel Universe. Pretty much a lot of this stuff is written by Peter David, also done by William Mitchell Lowe's, Jeff Loeb, Mark Waid, Dave Gibbons, Scott Lobdell, B.J. Edis, and Matt Wagner. Artwork by Anna Medina, Paul Politer, Ian Churchill, Adam Kubert, Mike Dill Jr., Mike McCone, Dave Gibbons, Sam Keith, Dave McCarr, Bill Brunhall, Bartel Ramos, Parker Ferry, Pat Cohen, Tim Sale, Joe Bennett. Wow. First up with Savage Hulk number 1. The stories in this book are Courtroom Sequence. Now, here's who does the books in here. They credit here. Courtroom Sequence, this is Peter David one. Old Friend, Dave Gibbons is basically writing an artwork for this one. Power of Bullies, that's William Mr. Lowe, who's Sam Keith and Dave McCard. The Strongest Area is the Scott Lobdell story. Brief BG is Matt Wagner does Vision Quest. Diners, Jeff Loeb and Tim Sale. And that's it. You mostly put the Savage Hulk, it's like an anthology book with various stories in here. Like him putting on a tryout for stuff related to Hulk. You also have the Rhino and the Thing and Juggernaut in this issue. It's just like a really good anthology issue. And yeah, they only use one comic in this damn thing. And then, like, right after this one wraps up, then we have for issues 136 to about 140 is known as Ghost of the Future, which is the title of this trade here. Which, by the way, they have the name of the storyline on here. Ghost of the Future, mostly put it just more Peter David awesome stuff here. With appearance by the leader. It also deals with, well, various, it's like a series of stuff happened over the course of these five issues. Let's see, I think, when does the Over the Edge issue come in? Cutting Edge, that comes up to 436. Yeah, they have Cutting Edge, Ghost of the Future. This is basically just a... This is William Mr. Loeb. This is just basically just they threw this here because it's part of the storyline. Yeah. It just deals with stuff with the leader. It's a really good storyline. And it's only five parts. Yeah, surprisingly it's only five parts plus the Cutting Edge issue. Gets wrapped up by 340. Where in the finale, he fights Thor. Because, of course, he fights Thor. Because, basically, Marvel loves putting these two together. And you're thinking, okay, so... You might be thinking, okay, so what's next? Well, let's have a few issues where She-Hulk takes over the title. Yes, She-Hulk takes over the title of about three issues in this book. Starting with issue 441, which the cover is a homage to the movie poster for Pulp Fiction. You might be asking, have I seen Pulp Fiction? Nope. I haven't. Where's the Hulk? They give him a break for a few issues. Yeah, basically, like, it goes from 241, I think wraps up with 243 or 244, where She-Hulk takes over the title. Yep. Yeah. And, I think with this issue here, I think this is when they wrap it up. Okay, yeah, it was actually just two issues, basically with She-Hulk, and then Hulk's back with issue 243 was with something related to Rick Jones and his daughter, possibly. And then we have the whole stuff with Onslaught, which is basically Cable team with Onslaught for a two-parter. No, Onslaught, the Hulk, which starts with the Cable issue and continues in Hulk. Incredible Hulk 444. Yep. And what happened here is that Wrath, this issue, then we have the one-shot Onslaught Marvel Universe, which is the inclusion of the Onslaught crossover. It's like, okay, let's throw basically Hulk's minor contribution to the story here. And then for the last few issues, it's basically what Hulk was doing Wrath, which, because he's actually one of those heroes who got killed off during the whole thing with Onslaught. Mostly just Avengers, Fantastic Four, and Thor. Yep. And, I think we have a new artist. Actually, just Angel Medina still does the artwork here. Yeah, basically, the last few issues here just mostly deals with what Hulk was up to during afterwards. And we have a new chapter. That was the 46. We have a new chapter. Just we have Mike Deodato on the artwork, which is awesome. I love Mike Deodato's artwork. Yeah, he starts doing the artwork with this issue. And basically just takes on some stuff, and that's it. It's just a lot of stuff that happens over the course of these issues. It's still pretty good. I'm giving the book a 9 out of 10. Yep. Alright, next up we have something I've never discussed before on my channel. Never. We have Cyber Force, The Complete Collection, Volume 1. Yes, this collects Cyber Force number 0. Also the first one, which is 4 issues. 2 issues of Wildcats. Issues 5 through 7. Basically a lot of Cyber Force. And I do mean a lot of Cyber Force. Now, do I have much history with Cyber Force? Not particularly, no. As a matter of fact, prior to reading, getting this straight here, the only Cyber Force I ever read was the most recent book they came out with. Yeah, I've never actually read anything related to Cyber Force before, so... Yeah, they have here the entire first volume for Cyber Force, the Wildcats issues, the first 13 issues of the volume, and they also have the first Origins issues for Origins. They also have Origins for number 1, Sideblade, Striker, and the annual, which is the first annual, which is done by David Finch. Yep. Mark Silvestri does, this is his book, basically he created this group. Yeah. Yeah, basically, it's created by Mark Silvestri. Now, in the back, they have the credits. Yes, the credits for who does all the issues. These are your credits for these issues. Issue 1, it's written by Eric Silvestri. Well, Mark Silvestri does the artwork. And that's your creative team for the original 4 issues. The issue 0 is basically Mark and Eric Silvestri, Walt Simonson on the writing artwork. The Wildcats issues is Jim Lee and Brandon Choi. Cyber Force, the relaunch, is done by the Silvestri brothers. Yep, and they pretty much do the entirety of the book. Yep. Yeah, the artwork does not get changed into issue number 8, where we have Tom McFarlane do an issue. Yes. Issue 9 is where they changed the writer finally. Eric Silvestri been since issue 1. We have Chris Klamm on the writing. Yep. The Origins Sideblade issue is written by Mike Holster, Mark Silvestri, and David Warhol. Eric Russell does a Striker issue. Cyber Force number 10 is still Chris Claremont. And he does issue 11. Then 12, basically, Eric Silvestri takes over and does 13. The annual is done by Mark Silvestri, David Holst, David Wall, with Dave Finch and the artwork. And these books came up for the period of October 1992. And the last issue of this book came out in June of 1985. As you can guess, it's Image. Early Image. It took months to release these issues. Like, first issue released in October 1982. Next issue was not released till 6 months, till like 5 months later. Then, like, so it's 2 months. Okay. They had like a couple things in the same month. Yeah. The members of this group are the following. You have Velocity, Ripclaw, Heatwave, Sideblade, Striker, Impact, and Ballistic. Yep. Yeah, Image decided to do this. Now, I personally have heard of Cyber Force. I've never read it before. I did much interest in getting to him, but this book basically just really good. The Wildcats, I was kind of familiar with because I read the books already. Basically, you have Grifter and Zanuck here, too. She's of course, popped up in DC Comics. Cyber Force, the only book I read for them aside from this was actually the revival they did, which lasted about a year, and that was it. But this is still pretty good. I give this book roughly a 9 out of 10. Okay, so that's episode review. Next up is going to be My Hero Academia. I'll take a break. Okay, thanks for you. Bye.